Hey guys, this is a short spoiler-free review about the book Descendant of the Crane, written by Joan He. Before we get into the story, let's take a quick look at the contents of the book. The book has a map that describes the different kingdoms and places that are involved in the story. Now, about the story. The book has three parts: Treason, Trial, and Truth. Princess Hesina of Yan finds that her father did not die of natural causes but was murdered. She becomes the Queen of Yan to go through trial for her father's murder to finally discover the truth behind his death. There, I gave away this just in few simple sentences, but there is a complicated history behind her father's reign. There are magical people called Suths who are being killed for their abilities. There is war between kingdoms for the abilities of Suths, and a weirdly complicated family and relationships. The book is considered a Chinese equivalent of Game of Thrones, but I honestly don't see a connection, not that I'm a fan. I have mixed feelings about this book. Hesina's character is made in such a way that she's just another human being who makes mistakes, which to some extent is acceptable. Her adamancy in finding the truth is also agreeable, but the way she describes or thinks of herself sometimes in more than in one instance as a bad person made me wonder what bad is she actually thinking about. That looks as an attempt made by author to not allow the reader to decide on her character but often doubt her. And the way the kingdom runs on itself is such a mystery. Also, there is no proper introduction about the Suths, which makes it really hard to understand their role in the story. It's like we get to know only when Hesina finds out their role, which is nearly halfway through the book. In the last part, Truth, she discovers the truth behind her father's death and more truth about the people in her life by being betrayed. Maybe the betrayals and unexpected twists are somewhat similar to Game of Thrones. What I disliked most was the ending. It was neither happy nor tragic. When you try to conclude it as a tragic, the author will give an alternate perspective which might make one hope for a happy ending. In other words, the ending will make you wonder if there is a second book, but there isn't. It is a standalone YA fantasy. Oh, and I almost forgot. I was never able to make a connection between Crane and Hesina or any of her siblings. Overall, the book was an okay read with all my expectations being crushed. With the beautiful cover and map, I really wished the book to be a fantastic read. I would rate it 3 out of 5 for the story. Maybe if there is a sequel with better explanation for all the confusions, it would be one of the best reads. Thank you for watching this video. If you like this review, hit the like button and subscribe to my YouTube channel. Keep reading books. Until the next review, this is Darshini signing off.